Dimple dies are specialty tools for strengthening sheet metal and plate steel by pressing a flare into the edges of a cut hole. They're perfect for any project that requires increased strength with less weight, which makes them ideal for automotive applications. And the flared holes make for a clean overall aesthetic. Most dimple dies are machined from solid steel and are meant to be used in an ironworker or press. Common sizes range from 1/2 inch to 2.5 inch, and they can flare metal as thick as 1/8 inch chromoly steel. You can get an 8-piece dimple die set for around $550, which isn't too bad if you plan on using them regularly, but maybe you only need to use them once or twice, or maybe you want to experiment with a few different sizes before you commit to buying some. So today, we're using a LulzBot TAZ Pro to 3D print dimple dies out of carbon fiber reinforced filament to see how they hold up to their steel counterparts. We started by 3D modeling a replica of these 1¼-inch and 2.5-inch steel dimple dies. The LulzBot TAZ Pro and TAZ Workhorse both feature hardened steel hot ends, which allows for printing with strong industrial strength materials like the colorFabb PACF carbon fiber filament we're using for this project. We tested this filament in a prior video and were shocked at how well it held up to high strength applications. We're using 19 gauge aluminum sheet and 28, 22, and 16 gauge steel sheet metal for our test. A drill press is used to cut the center holes. The dies are inserted into the holes, sandwiched into a hydraulic press, and pressure is applied until the dies are completely collapsed. It's that easy. Here we have our finished dimple-dyed pieces. You can see they turned out fantastic. We have the steel and the 3D printed ones next to each other for comparison. This one is the 16 gauge steel, which is the thickest of the materials that we tried, and you can see that it's incredibly stiff and rigid. You might be able to tell that on the 2.5-inch dies, the flare is slightly different on the 3D printed ones than with the steel versions. That was because we modeled the dimple dies before we had gotten the actual steel dies in-house. But actually, this works really well to highlight why a 3D printed die would be favorable, because maybe you want a slightly less or slightly more aggressive flare on your dimple dies. We also thought about experimenting with some different infill settings to make the dies themselves a little stronger, but what we found is that when you're pressing into the layer lines on the printed piece, the 20% with the carbon fiber filament was tough enough to handle all the abuse that we threw at it, and again, 16 gauge steel is incredibly tough and rigid. This worked so well, we're excited to try some other 3D printed tooling applications, maybe some brake dies or some custom shapes and sizes on dimple dies. So let us know in the comments what you would like to see, and thanks for watching.